today, amen, for another opportunity to come into the Lord's house and give the Lord some praise, amen. God has been good to us,
yes.
Amen. We have a reason to give the Lord some praise, amen. And this time, amen, the praise team is going to come, amen, and render a few selections and lead us in worship service. Let's say amen for them as they come at this time.
Amen. We come to magnify the Lord on this morning. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, thank you, Father, Lord.
everybody hand praise. We love him once more. There is none like him in all the earth. Amen. I haven't found anybody like him, have you? Amen. There is none like you. And we come to let him know, God, there is none like you. I don't serve anyone but you. You are the greatest in the world. Amen. Hallelujah. Just think about what he's done, how great he is. How great of God to serve. Thank you.
of praise. Amen. If you can remain standing, amen. Deacon Thompson is coming with our morning invocation. Let's say amen for him as he comes at this time.
First, giving honor to my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Wouldn't have been for the Lord, I wouldn't even woke up this morning.
Amen.
I want to thank Pastor Austin. Give me time to pray this morning. And First Lady Austin for the congregation. But one thing I like about the Lord, when you're in need, he always sends somebody. And I just pray along with you this morning. Abba Father, with you on him. I be thy name, God, Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, I'm coming to you. Just thank you, Heavenly Father, all my many blessings, Heavenly Father. Thank you for watching over my step last night, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, we just thank you for a roof over our head, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, we praying to you, Heavenly Father, because you brought us a mighty long way, Heavenly Father. Bless the sick and afflicted this morning, Heavenly Father. Heavenly Father, everybody that's here this morning, help us to have church this morning, Heavenly Father. Help us to just forget about our problems and lift up your holy name, Heavenly Father. And touch our pastor right now, Heavenly Father. Help him to give us a word, Heavenly Father. The word that can hold us all week, Heavenly Father. We just praying to you, Heavenly Father. Just thanking you, Heavenly Father. If I had a million voices, I couldn't thank you, Heavenly Father, enough, because you've been so good this week, Heavenly Father. I just want to say thank you, Heavenly Father. Thank you for me listening to the praise this morning, Heavenly Father. And being able to walk into your house this morning, Heavenly Father. Just thank you, Heavenly Father. Help us to have church right now, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name, I pray again.
Come on, tell the Lord thank you in this house. Amen. We thank God. Amen. For prayer. Amen. And our scripture reading will be coming from Proverbs chapter 22. And verse number 1. It says, a good name is rather to be chosen than great riches. And loving favor rather than silver and gold. The rich and the poor meet together. The Lord is the maker of them all. A prudent man foreseeth the evil and hides himself, but the simple pass on and are punished. By humility and for fear of the Lord are riches and honor of life. May the Lord bless the reading, the hearing of his word for the edification of our soul in Jesus' name. Thank God. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. It is a wonderful day. Amen. That God has made. Amen. This is Memorial Weekend. Amen. And we want to thank God. Amen. For all of the military and veterans. Amen. Those that have served. Amen. In the military, or are serving in the military. Amen. We do honor you on today. Amen. At this time, we're going to have another selection from the praise team. Let's say amen for them as they come at this time.
I'm going to use Still Believe God.
There's also people that are coming in town, and everyone's getting their holiday meals together. Amen. So we are grateful for that. Amen. I want to say congratulations to all of the graduating class of 2021. Amen. Let's say amen for the graduating class. Amen. We know that some children have graduated. Amen. As we said last week, I think Sister Torres' daughter graduated last week with her master's degree. Amen. Amen. For education. God plus education equals success. Amen. Amen. I want to just talk about a few things this morning in your hearing. And one of the famous sayings of Mark Twain, amen, two of the most important days of a man or a woman's life is when he or she was born and the reason he finds out why. Amen. A lot of times, amen, we are born into the world. Amen. And we have to deal with many of things that we are not prepared or ready to deal with. Amen. But God have blessed us to be in this world. Amen. To deal with a lot of things. Amen. And sometimes we deal with a lot of unforeseen issues. Amen. But God blesses us to get through all of them. Amen. Amen. This morning, if you would stand to your feet, I want to take your attention to Matthew chapter 6, verse 33. Matthew chapter 6, verse 33. Amen. We're only going to deal with one scripture on this morning. Matthew chapter 6, verse 33 says, "Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things will be added unto you." This morning I want to talk for a few moments on prayer. priorities. Priorities. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord.
Go ahead, Pastor.
Amen. I was trying to be quiet and give the cue to Missionary Ginger because she was all up in the message in Sunday school. Praise the Lord. Amen. We're grateful for all that God has done. Amen. We thank God for Mother Kenny and Mother Barna. Amen. Missionary Ginger. Amen. Deacon. Bless you. Amen. Amen. God bless. Amen. Sister Fisher and Sister Dorsey. Amen. Come on, let's give each other a big hand. Amen. I want to talk here. Amen. First, we need to prioritize our relationship with God. Prioritize our relationship with God. Amen. And what that entails to us is we have to take out a little bit of time to stay committed to God. And you know, as I thought about this, as God gave it to me, we're dealing with a time where people are not so committed anymore. They're not committed to God. They're not committed to the work of the Lord. They're not committed in relationships. There's a lack of commitment. Even doctors now are not committed to being a health practice. They want you to come in and make the copay, and they check your bios, and then they want to send you down the road and give you some medicine that may not have anything to do with how you're feeling or the reason that you came to the physician in the first place. They're not committed. The Bible says here in 1 Kings chapter 8, verse 6, and the scripture is on the screen. It says, the priest then brought the ark of the Lord's covenant to its place in the inner sanctuary of the temple, the most holy place, and put it beneath the wings of the cherubim. I want to begin to let you know that every head of the household, whether man or woman, is the priest of their house. And it starts, our priority starts as being responsible for being the spiritual leader in our home.
The work must begin in the house. Then it must begin as we take on the responsibility as becoming a Christian, a leader in the church. It begins with the work in the house of the Lord. I want to express my concern and my interest in you on today that your commitment to the house of the Lord is important to me, and it is important to God. The reason why is because God honors your commitment to the work, the house of the Lord. And when you take care of God's business, God will take care of yours. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. We must stay committed to God. Proverbs 16:3 says, "Commit thy works unto the Lord, and thy thoughts shall be established." You know, that's interesting to me, because when you are committed to the work of the Lord, it's something here that God said that he does. He establishes your thoughts. It's almost as if when you are committed to doing what God has called you to do, he helps your thinking process. He helps you to figure out things that normally you cannot figure out. He helps you to be able to wrap your mind around situations that may seem to puzzle you. He establishes your thoughts. And the reason why I believe he establishes your thoughts is because when you're committed to God's work, he sets you up for success. It's something about serving God. Nowadays, people want to serve God when there is a crowd or an audience. And I come to find out that in the time in which we're living in, the only audience that we need is God.
Right.
Yeah. Amen. You know, people are not pleased. People want to be entertained. We are living in an entertainment society now. And everything seems to be on the level of a reality show.
Right.
You can make me laugh, and you can, if it's messy, seems like people are driven off listening to mess. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing to people. I believe that's why so many individuals, get involved with reality shows, Housewives of whatever city it is, and they get involved with that because people love mess, and seems like people love negativity more than good. It's almost as if that Something good is boring. And mess is exciting. There was a young boy that had that same mentality. And his grandmother told him, don't keep going out in the field and playing around the cesspool. You all know the cesspool was a place where the hogs and the pigs laid their waste. And so the young boy did not heed to the instruction and the priority of staying clean because he enjoyed mess. And so one day he went down into the field and he began to play around the cesspool. And then he slipped and he fell into the cesspool. Of course, he got himself out, and when he got himself out, he tried to come back into his grandmother's house. Well, you all know the story. Grandma said, you're not coming in my house. Yeah. Smelling like mess. Y'all ain't gonna say that. Right? Amen. What am I trying to say? Amen. That God has, amen, a plan. He has a way of doing things in order for us to be blessed. We must stay committed to God. Romans chapter 12, verses 1 through 2 says, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that ye present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. But let me just stop there, amen. The least we can do is to live holy for God.
That's right.
Amen. Our service, amen, is to be committed to God. When we take, amen, the vow, the oath, when we get baptized, whatever you want to call it, amen, when we say that we're saved, amen, we have just vowed to stay committed to God. In a marriage, amen, when we take, amen, vows, we take a, amen, a stance that we would be committed to the relationship. We must understand, amen, that in this life of serving God, amen, we are committed. We are in a spiritual marriage with God. God is expecting, amen, us to be faithful to him. Amen. Not some of the time, but all of the time. Amen. I want to, amen, say this, amen, and I'm going to say it throughout the message, amen. God have made a priority, amen, to look after your life so you can live, amen, and you should make a priority to look to God so you should not die.
Amen.
Amen, amen, amen. The second verse, amen, says here, we should not be conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is good and acceptable and perfect will of God. We, amen, should not conform, amen. Paul here deals with conformity, amen. And now we live in a time, amen, where you cannot, amen, tell the difference between the saints and the sinners. Amen. We must, amen, have a mindset, amen, to be different. Amen. We must have the mindset to be an example to the people around us. Amen. And I just want to let you know, amen, if the people around you cannot see the commitment to God, amen, then we have just taught them that they don't need to be committed to God. Amen. People, amen, learn often by what they see you do. If you're not committed to God, amen, then the people around you will say, well, I'm going to do what I see them do. Praise the Lord. Amen. I know this is a tough message. Amen. I'll get to, amen, a little candy, a little cotton candy in a little bit. Amen. We must prioritize, amen, your family. We must have family values. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 1, amen, verses 1 through 6 says, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Amen. Children don't want to listen to the parents. Nowadays, they want to tell the parents what they will and what they will not do. Amen. We grew up where the parents instilled fear and reverence and respect in us. Amen. And till this day, amen, we respect our parents. We respect our elders, but nowadays, amen. And we must get back to these priorities. It talks about honor thy father and thy mother. Amen. And that is a sensitive subject for me. The reason why is because, amen, sometimes children will do everything, amen, mama said. Amen. And they look at dad, amen, as a foreign object. Amen. But, you know, we're going to need each other. Amen. Children need both parents. Amen. 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 And I don't know your situation, but my situation is different. Amen. I have a problem, amen, when I want to see my children. I have rights to see my children. But because the mother is in another relationship, she wants to keep the children away from me in order to, amen, prioritize her other relationship. Amen. But I come to let you know, amen, that other relationship don't have nothing to do with me. My priority is about my children. I want to let you know, amen, and it is, amen, Men's Day today. Amen. There's still some good fathers in the world. Amen. Everyone's not, amen, a deadbeat dad. Amen. I pays my child support. Okay. Amen. I picks up my children. Amen. I buys them tennis shoes and all of that stuff. Amen. But we must have priorities. Amen. Amen. And no matter, amen, how the relationship ended, amen, in your family, amen, we cannot teach the children against their other half, amen, because the Bible says, honor thy father and thy mother. Amen. This is the first commandment with a promise. Amen. That it may be well with them, and that thou may liveth long on the earth. The moment that a child disobeys their parents, God cuts their days. It's a dangerous thing for a child not to honor their parents. Amen. It goes on, amen, and it says, and fathers, provoke not the children to wrath, and bring them up in the nurture and admonition of the Lord. Mm-hmm. Fathers are, amen, they have a responsibility, amen, to be, amen, amen, the spiritual, amen, force behind, amen, raising the children up in the Lord. Amen. I believe the reason why some children don't go, amen, to church is because the father didn't get behind the mother. Amen. And when the mother went to church, the father should have said, go with your mama to church. Amen. But instead, they wanted to stay home with the children and play hooky. Amen. The servants, amen, it talks about, amen, servants being obedient to the masters, amen, according to the flesh, amen, and with fear and trembling and singleness of heart, amen, and as unto Christ. But, amen, we got to understand, amen, God has an order to being blessed. Amen. I'm getting ready, amen, to close, amen. There's a few things, amen, we must prioritize, amen, your time, your money, amen, amen. The Bible says in Proverbs 3:9, amen, honor the Lord with thy substance and with the first fruits of all thine increase. Amen. Saints of God, we need to learn how to manage your time, your talent, and your treasure. Amen. We need to, amen, have a journal, amen, and jot down what we're doing, what our schedule is, and how we're going to do things, amen. Sometimes, amen, God, amen, can't give us more because we're not managing, amen, what he's already given us. Amen. And I know this may bore you today. Amen. But amen. It's, amen. It's relevant. Amen. We need to prioritize our time. Amen. Time and money management. Amen. We need to prioritize our talents, amen. What we're doing for God, amen. God doesn't expect us, amen, to be in the house of the Lord, amen, and do nothing. God have given us all skills. God have given everyone something to do to be able to bless someone else, amen. I just want to let you know, amen, that you are a gift from God. Amen. And I want to let you know that you are a gift, amen, to each other. You are a gift to me. Amen. And then I just want to let you know, amen, that, amen, I love everybody. Amen. I love everybody the same. Amen. I value everybody. I talk to everybody. I text everybody. I show the love for everybody. I try to help everybody because I want to let you know that you are important to me. Amen. And as a pastor, amen, you are my priority to make sure that you are doing okay. Hallelujah. Amen. I try, amen, to do this because God has given me this talent. Amen. Everyone, amen, don't have the same love. Everyone don't have the same care. Amen. I want to let you know there's some people in the world that may not care nothing about you. Amen. This is why, amen, God have called pastors according to his own heart. Amen. He called, amen, the pastor, amen, to show that love, to show that concern. Amen. Because you are a gift to the body of Christ. Amen. I want to let you know, amen, we must begin to prioritize, amen, our prayer and devotional life. Amen. I want to let you know, amen, we need to pray more. Amen. Amen. Sometimes, amen, it's just not good enough. Amen. The Bible says that men and women ought to always pray. Amen. We need to love prayer. Amen. I found out, amen, some years ago, as I was going through some things on the job, amen, before I started my own business back then, amen, I told this testimony in Sunday school that I was having trouble, amen, with a supervisor, and he, amen, would constantly get in my face, amen, because he was much bigger than me. He thought that, amen, he can bully me. Hallelujah, amen. I wanted to let him know, amen, don't let the size of my stature, amen, convince you that you're gonna beat me. Amen. I went, amen, home, and I got down on my knees. Amen. I began to seek the face of the Lord. Amen. And when I began to seek the face of the Lord, I told God about that supervisor. Amen. I went back to work the next day. And the supervisor came up to me. And he said, "Can I talk to you for a moment?" And I said, "What is it now?" He said, "I had a dream." And when he said that, I looked, and he said, "God visited me in a dream, and God said to leave you alone." I began to give God the praise right there on the job. Amen. What I'm trying to tell you is that when you put prayer first, hallelujah, before your situation, it don't matter, amen, who the individual is, amen, that man was not a believer, but God, amen, came into his dream and told him, "Don't mess with the man of God." Hallelujah. What am I trying to tell y'all? Amen. When you want to prioritize your life, stay humble to God. 2 Chronicles 7:14 says, "If my people, which are called by my name, should humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from the wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven, and I will forgive the sin, and I will heal their land." Somebody say, it's praying time. Hallelujah. I know it's just a few of us in here. Hallelujah. But holler across the room. Hallelujah. And tell them, "I know what prayer can do." Hallelujah. We need to stay focused on God. Isaiah 26:3 said that I would keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed on thee, because he trusteth in thee. Hallelujah. I want to let you know that God will keep your mind. Hallelujah. Sometimes we can get our minds on so many things, but he said he'll keep your mind in perfect peace. If we keep our mind stayed on the Lord, hallelujah, look at somebody and tell them, "I got Jesus on my mind." Say amen. Amen. We got to stay in the Word. 2 Timothy 3:16 through 17. He said, "All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof and correction, and for instruction in righteousness." He didn't say some scripture, but he said all scripture. It's profitable. If you want to do something great in God, hallelujah, the word
The word of God will help you to go higher. The word of God will help you to go great, do greater things in the Lord. The man of God, hallelujah, may, amen, be perfect, thoroughly furnished through all good works. There's something about staying committed to God, because when I'm committed to God, God can move, amen, obstacles out of the way. When I'm committed to God, God can fight my enemies. When I'm committed to God, I can prosper in the way that God, hallelujah, want me to prosper. Clap those hands and give God some praise. Hallelujah. I'm closing here. Hallelujah. The next thing I want you to understand, amen, about priorities. Amen. Stay healthy. And prosper. Psalms 27, 3 through 5 says, though an host shall encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though a war should rise against me, in this will I be confident. The one thing I desire of the Lord, that I may seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. There's something about being in the house of the Lord. Amen. Don't worry. Amen. Because there's not many people here. Amen. But when you are in the house of the Lord, amen, you have made a decision to come into the presence of God. And in the presence of God, there is the fullness of glory. In the presence of God, there is liberty. There's something about being in the presence of God. There doesn't need to be 1,000 people in the house of the Lord for you to get your blessing. Hallelujah. All it takes is you to be in the house of the Lord. Hallelujah. Being in the right place at the right time. God can bless you anywhere. Hallelujah. He's Alpha. He is Omega. He is the beginning and the end. Hallelujah. There's something about the presence of God. Because when I'm in the presence of God, I feel safe. In the presence of God, I feel good. In the presence of God, hallelujah, he holds my mind. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing here. Sometimes when things around me is going wrong, all I need to do is get in the presence of God. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing here, because there's something about God. Hallelujah, when I'm in his presence, hallelujah, God has the capability of being a fence around about me. He protects me from hurt, harm, and danger. Hallelujah. There's something about my God. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing. It's the reason that we say today. It's the reason, hallelujah, that we come to church, because in the presence of God, there's the fullness of his glory. Hallelujah. The Bible says that in the presence of his glory, we behold the beauty of the Lord. Taste and see, hallelujah, that the Lord is good. Have God been good to anybody out there? Have God made a way for anybody out there? Have God brought you out of anything? in tribulations. Hallelujah. And at the end of the day, you said that was nobody but God. Hallelujah. I need you to give a but God praise. Hallelujah. Oh, if I just think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for me, my soul cries out. Hallelujah. Thank God. Some of y'all need to tell God, thank you. Because he's been so good. Hallelujah. Don't you know somebody did not wake up this morning, but God woke you up. You need to tell God, thank you. He's still performing miracles. God is doing great things for us. Hallelujah. And I just stopped by to let you know that a great God deserves great praise. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing. Hallelujah. I feel like preaching. Hallelujah. Oh, from the rising of the sun to the going down of the same. Somebody say the Lord is worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. He's done great things. Hallelujah for me. Hallelujah. I may not have it the way that I want it, but God has made a way. He's looked over my children. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Kept her from her harm and danger. I said, God is good. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing to me. I got a house to live in. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I don't got one floor, I got two floors. Hallelujah. Matter of fact, I got three floors that I can walk up and down in. I said, God is good. Hallelujah. I got enough room I can go and lay in one side of the floor. Go on the other side and lay on another side. I said, God is good. Hallelujah. I can look out the window and see what God has gave me. Hallelujah. Is there anybody here that can say God has been good to them? Hallelujah. God has been good. Hallelujah. Down through the years, God has been good. He's brought me out of darkness into his marvelous light. Hallelujah. I could have been dead, resting in my grave, but God don't save me. He don't save me from accidents. Hallelujah. He saved me from falling. He saved me from gunshots. He saved me from drugs. He saved me from folk that wanted to kill me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's why I praise God. Because God don't brought me out of so much that anybody else can bring me out of. Y'all ain't gonna say nothing here. God has been an instrument in my life. Hallelujah. That's why I praise God. Y'all ain't saying nothing here. Hallelujah. I could have died years ago. Hallelujah. Amen. I went through something. I got sick in my body. Went down to Yuma to preach. Amen. Came back. I couldn't even breathe. Amen. I told my wife, rush me to the hospital. Amen. Went to the hospital. Hallelujah. And they said if I had not made it there, amen, 20 minutes earlier, I would have died. My oxygen level was below 7. Hallelujah. But I come to let you know that God is the type of God that sees you as a priority. He sees you as valuable. When you could have died, God said, live. Somebody amen, saw you as a priority, yeah, so you can live. Now you need to see God as a priority, yeah, so you won't die. Yeah, y'all ain't gonna say nothing to me. Yeah, amen. He keeps on. I'm closing now. He keeps on, amen, making a way out of no way. Yeah, verse 5 is in the middle of trouble. He shall hide me in his pavilion, in the secret of his tabernacle. He shall hide me. Yeah, he shall set me up, amen, upon a rock. Yeah. Hallelujah. He shall hide me. Yeah. Hallelujah. God is the type of God, amen, that when trouble comes, he'll hide you. Hallelujah. He'll take you, amen, and spread out his wings. He'll hide you. So the Bible says in Psalm 91, he that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I would say, he is my shield and my buckler. I said, my God shall supply all of my needs according to his riches. Hallelujah. And his glory. Hallelujah. Somebody say amen. Hallelujah. Jesus, somebody shout Jesus. He came that we may have life, and that we may have life more abundantly. I'm talking to a few folks that's living the abundant life. If it had not been for the Lord who was on our side, where would we be? Hallelujah. Can we have testimony service? Is there anybody here that can say, hallelujah, God have done so many great things in my life. Look across the room and tell them, if it had not been for God, where would I be? God is a good God. I need a few people that know that God is good. I need a few people that know that God is a good God. Hallelujah. I feel something in here. Hallelujah. Somebody say that God is a miracle worker. Somebody say that God is a savior. Somebody tell somebody how good God is. Say yes. Say yes. God have brought me. Hallelujah. Is there anybody here that can say that song? He keeps on doing great things for me. Hallelujah. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Hallelujah. Glory to God. You got a right to give God praise. You got a right to magnify the Lord. You got a right to give him glory. He's done so much. I cannot tell it all. If I had 10,000 tongues, I still could praise him enough. When I look back over my life and see where the Lord has brought me from, he's brought me from a mighty long way. He brought me from a came. I'm done, I'm done. Amen. He's came to give us the abundant life. He said in his word, 3 John chapter 1, verse 1 through 2, we're standing this day. The elder unto the well-beloved Gaius, whom I love in truth. He said, beloved, I wish above all things that you may prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospers. You know, God doesn't want us going through. He wants us to prosper. He wants us to prosper in health and in our daily activities. But you know what happens is, amen, this is true. What I'm going to say. I've seen people that they've been with God, they're busy in the church, and somehow you get tired. You get tired, you stop coming to church. After you stop coming to church, it seems like your spiritual life and your finances and everything begins to decline. Somehow, by the grace of God, individuals find themselves coming back to God, coming back to church. And then God takes them and builds them back up. The thing is that puzzles me is that if God was blessing you when you were committed, why walk away from that which works? Now hear what I'm telling you today. When we break commitment, we break success. You hear what I'm telling you? The only way to be successful is that you have to have God in the equation.
All the time.
The moment we break some type of commitment or fellowship, we break the camaraderie with God. Let me just say it like this. In a relationship, if you stop talking and seeing someone, by rights, you have turned your back on them and broken the connection that you once had. Therefore, there is no more relationship. Because what was there has been cut. In order to be in connection with someone, there has to be some type of communication. In order to be connected to God,
little Dell will not do it. It takes more. Watch this. It's the last time I'm going to say this. If God saw you as a priority to give his life so you can live, we should make God our priority so we cannot die. You'll get that maybe next week when you go home. I don't know. But we have to understand is the moment that we break that commitment with God is the moment we spiritually die. Are you hearing what I'm saying? And I don't know about you. You know, some people can go without God a couple weeks, you know, a couple months. But I need more. Y'all hear what I'm saying? Because if I don't have more God, I'll get more me. And if I get more me, that's trouble. Don't you know us is our own or worst enemy? That's the truth. Because if I allow me to do me, then the devil gonna get so much in me that I'm gonna do some stuff that's not going to bring glory to God. Only shame. And so I'm and maybe y'all are stronger than me, but I need more of God. And so I'm committed. I know you've been standing. I'm going to pray. Someone had said they needed a break from church. They said they was tired. They was tired of teaching. I said to the first lady, I said, well, what about us? I don't get no break. Am I right? I'm here every Sunday, Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday, start all over sometime Monday, state meetings, district meeting, and work, and I'm getting tired. So the Bible says this, be not weary in well-doing. In due season, you should reap if you faint not. We should never get tired of doing the work of God. Because we'll receive a payday that's much greater than any payday that we can ever receive down here. You know, sometime when God, when this just happened, I'm going to pray you, man. We're going home. Because I got some ribs I'm going to put on the grill too. Praise the Lord. God keeps reminding me. Last week I found $50 doing the yard work out there. And in this suit I haven't worn in 6 months, and I put my hand in my pocket and found some other money. I said, the Lord keep on reminding me that if you be faithful for a few things, all God's saying, just be faithful for a little bit. Be committed to God. Don't let nobody try to tell you, you don't take all that. Listen, y'all from the old school, they told us it takes all the hands some. Some of our mothers and grandmothers and pawpaws and all that, they made it because of being faithful. They was in church all the time. And it didn't kill them, it made them better. They knew how to get a prayer through. Their mind was sharp. Let me pray. Lord God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this word and these your people. We ask, oh God, that you would help them be more committed than they are. Most of all, God, I pray that you touch them to be committed, because we need them in the church. I, as pastor, can't do everything by myself. First lady can't do everything by myself. We need the people of the Lord's help to be more committed to the work of the Lord. God, we ask that as we challenge them on this day, that you will give them their reward for their faithfulness. In Jesus' name, thank God. Come on, put those hands together. Amen. We're getting ready to receive our offering and go home. Amen. Those that give by, give the five, or by envelope. Amen. Thank God for you all. You all have been a blessing to the church. Amen.